It's Espresso Billionaire Week Part 2, where I dig into my archives to bring you 5 lessons from 5 of the richest people in the world over the next 5 days. Up today with a net worth of $72.5 billion is Steve Ballmer.
Ideas matter. I talked about this a little bit. I spoke at the big commencement at USC 3 years ago. And yet, as I was really going through what I needed to say to you, I have to reinforce this notion that ideas matter. People think business is about leadership. They think it's about working hard. They think it's about a lot of things, which it is. But at the end of the day, the ideas that you have will power the organizations that you join. They will create the value. A great team, great energy, and great hard work will never make up for a bad idea. Now, bad ideas can also fall flat on the floor for a lot of other reasons. Windows and the power of the microprocessor, great idea. Great idea. And ideas matter. Even if you turn around and look at your own sort of personal lives, the idea, what you choose to do, does matter. You don't have to make a right choice, a perfect choice, now as you graduate. But what you really need to do is constantly ask yourself, am I pursuing the right idea in my life, in my career, for my company? Is this really something that will create value? Because at the end of the day, if the idea is wrong, you will fail.
I agree that ideas matter. I agree that ideas are important, and creative ideas and trusting the ideas. What I would add to it is that you have to go out and execute on the ideas too, because a lot of people have great ideas. I'm sure you guys, being an entrepreneur audience, have tons of great ideas, but you have to go out and start making progress on those great ideas for anything great to happen. Because if the idea just sits in your head and you don't do anything about it, what you're gonna find is somebody else capitalizes on your idea, right? Somebody else goes out and makes tons of money, has a huge impact, and you sit there and say, that was my idea. That person stole my idea. Where really, it's on you, because you didn't go out and execute. So when you come up with this great idea, you've got to go out and start taking action. Even if it's small, even if it's super tiny, some tiny little step every single day to move forward on it. And you may not have the resources or connections or knowledge or people around you or anything yet to make it happen. But part of entrepreneurship is figuring it out as you go. Yes, you can have a great plan. Yes, you don't just dive in and say, ooh, I wonder what's gonna happen. You wanna have a roadmap, but you won't have all the pieces together either. And there's gonna be a lot of unexpected things and roadblocks that get put in your way. And entrepreneurship is about being resourceful and finding a way around it, figuring it out partly as you go. And so if you're that person, that's where you're at right now, and you have this great idea, and you think you can have a huge impact and make a lot of money and change the world somehow through that idea, stop waiting. Stop waiting for the funding to come in, or for that ideal client to come in, or for whoever to win the presidential election. Like, none of that matters. What matters is you taking action today and tomorrow and the next day to move one step closer to making that idea happen. Ideas matter, and you have to execute on it. So the question today is, I'm curious, are you guys executing to your full capacity? You've got this great idea. Are you really, deeply, truly, honestly, actually executing on it or not? Leave it in the comments below, and I'm gonna join in the discussion. Thank you guys so much for watching. Have an amazing day. Continue to believe, and I'll see you again tomorrow morning for another shot of Espresso.
I mean, the reality is, reading a book or going to a conference or having a great conversation where you get this golden information, that's all fantastic. But what makes mastery is execution on the ideas, not the ideas. And so no idea works unless you're willing to roll up your sleeves, do the practice, invest the time, put in the effort, do the work. I think we've all observed a lot of people who, they love reading the books, they love showing up at the courses, they do all the online training, and nothing ever changes. And they say, well, you know, I don't know why it doesn't change, why my life doesn't change, why my thinking doesn't change, why my performance doesn't change, why my relationships don't change. Well, it's because ideas don't work if you don't execute on them. So if you look at the great business builders, you look at any great performer, one thing that makes them great is their grit. One thing that makes them great is their hunger to practice. One thing that makes them great is they are willing to sacrifice. I mean, yes, they're passionate, but did you know the root of the word passion is suffering? You've got to be willing to suffer for your vision. You've got to be willing to suffer to reach BIW, best in world. You've got to be willing to suffer the ridicule and laughter of your critics and your cynics to get to a place called world class.
My assistant's got a great thing now in this. Once in every 4 months, somebody sends an email saying, I've got a huge startup that I want you to invest in, but you've got to sign this NDA, right? Which literally every time gets an email back that says, you, right? And the reason is, I'm a humongous believer that ideas are and that execution's the game, right? We've all got ideas. Everybody's got ideas. Do you make ideas we all have here? We could probably sit here for the next 2 hours, draw them all out, record them, and predict the next 78 great startups over the next 9 years. And? So I think the thing that is another theme in entrepreneurship is there is way too much fodder brought to the idea. Uber was Magic Cab 3 years earlier. Uber is not an idea. Uber existed. It's called Magic Cab. But the guys that executed it sucked. So they lost. So I think, you know, if there's any level of romance left in this room about your idea, I'd like to suffocate it. Because I think the actual situation is what you actually do with it.
If you want to change your life for the next 30 days, check out my free training right here below. Or if you want to learn from the 9th richest person in the world, Larry Ellison, check the video right there next to me. I think you'll enjoy them. Continue to believe, and I'll see you there.